Writing Freedom by Pam Munez Ryan. This is based on a true story. Here is a brief description of the characters. Charlotte is fierce and strong, and she's not afraid of anything. She's a tomboy, and she doesn't care what anyone thinks of her. Her parents died when she was only 2, and she's lived in the orphanage ever since. Vern takes care of the horses and the stables at the orphanage. He was born into slavery, and he ran away when he was a young man. He is a kind, wise man who is a mentor to Charlotte. Hayward has bright red hair, freckles, and huge ears. He has a heart of gold. He is Charlotte's best friend. She looks out for him and makes sure none of the older boys mess with him. Ebenezer gives Charlotte a job and a way out of her former life. Over time, he becomes like a father to her. Here is a brief description of the plot. When Charlotte was 2, she was placed in the orphanage when her parents died. She was placed in the kitchen right away to help the cook. From the time she was little, Charlotte was strong and a good help. The cook realized how hard Charlotte worked and didn't want anyone to adopt her, so the cook hid Charlotte away when adults would come to the orphanage to adopt a child. As soon as Charlotte finished in the kitchen, she'd go straight to the stable with Vern. Charlotte had a special way with the horses. She'd feed them, take care of them, and race them. She always beat all the boys, even if they were older. 2 terrible things happened to Charlotte all at once. The first was that Hayward, who was like her little brother, was adopted. Then the director of the orphanage forbade her from working in the stables or riding horses because it wasn't fitting for a young lady. Charlotte decides it's time to run away. The issue is girls can't be unaccompanied. It's against the law. So she cuts her hair, puts on Hayward's old clothes, and she runs away as a boy. She ends up living her entire life as a boy and later as a young man. She becomes one of the greatest stagecoach drivers in the country. Ebenezer helps her along the way. He knows the truth about her, but he doesn't tell her that he knows, and he certainly doesn't tell anyone else. Towards the end of the book, he asks for her real name, and he tells her that she reminds him of his daughter who passed away. At the end of the story, Charlotte saves enough money to buy a ranch, and Hayward and Ebenezer come to live with her. She supports the women who are fighting for their vote to write. I'm sorry, for their right to vote. She votes in the election for the candidate who is in favor of letting women vote. She votes for all the women who can't vote, and she votes for Vern, who can't vote because he's black. She tells Hayward that she may one day tell the world the truth about herself. She says that even if she does, she won't change one thing about the way she's living. The focus here is still characters in depth and theme. Students are now working on both vocabulary and context and non-literal language at the same time. They continue to do the warm-up every day with you at the guided reading table. From here, I recommend that you go into the lesson plan, read all the focus questions and the exemplar responses, and you will be all set to teach this book.